God works all things together for good. Amen. Amen. And I believe the theme, Aaron, you said, was
the new.
Amen. The new. The new. How many like new things? Hallelujah. Now, the new. And that's good. And we're going to talk about that. And I'm a man of faith. How many believe I'm a man of faith? Amen. I am a man of faith. And whew, all that I have is by faith sometimes. I think I do too good of a job. And people think other things about me. But I believe in God just like the next man. Amen. But the scriptures tell us and reveal to us that faith is the only thing that can please God. Hallelujah. And without it, we can't please Him. Amen? Amen. And with this faith, hallelujah, you got to work it. Someone said, you better work it. Hallelujah. Faith is described in the Bible. It's quantified. It's sometimes referred to as strong faith. Sometimes it's referred to as weak faith. Sometimes it's referred to as legitimate faith. They use the word feign or pretended or real. How many remember the moment when you had to have real faith? Hallelujah. Amen. And you find out what you're made of, and you find out what you really believe, because what you believe is what you do, hallelujah, when you're called on the carpet to do it. Hallelujah. And God will make sure the just live by faith. Amen. Hallelujah. Now, I said I'm a person of faith, but others that know me, I'm also a person of fashion. Amen. And nothing wrong with living holy and looking good while you're doing it. Hallelujah. You just ought to. There should be one and the same. If Jesus decided to walk through here and manifest himself in the natural, all eyes would be on Jesus. Hallelujah. Even the spiritual gang, my spiritual gangster over there would say, sorry, baby, Jesus got you. And I would say, yeah, but he created me. Amen. Hallelujah. But nonetheless, I'm a person of faith. And, you know, my wife and I, let's give First Lady a hand. Amen. She takes care of the man of God. Not an easy job. Amen. But she does it well. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I can't tell people how good I got it, because I'll be like Abraham. Some king will try to come down and throw over my shoulder. Hallelujah. But just like Abraham, let him try to touch him. Y'all don't want to talk to me. Hallelujah. You got to keep reading. Amen. That whole kingdom got shut down. Amen. Hallelujah. He sent Abraham back with his wife and some silver and some gold and a decree. Keep playing. Amen. Hallelujah. But I'm man of fashion, and this is with the new. Hallelujah. Following in the theme. Hallelujah. And also what God is doing in his kingdom. And we always ask, what's your theme this year? What message are you sending forth? And we're talking about fashion. What's your theme this year? And sometimes you go, she'll say, well, rocker. Sometimes you'll say, well, Halle Berry, or, you know, whatever's going on. What's your theme? And I said, well, and she kept asking me this year. And I said, well, my theme this year, we usually ask around, like, the end of the summer, in the autumn, into winter. And I said, well, my theme, wasn't slow to answer concerning what my theme was. And I said, my theme this year is modern classic. And she said, what do you mean? I said, well, I'm going to take the same old things that never have gone out of style, that always are appropriate, that you can't go wrong with it, but I'm gonna add a modern twist to it. So, for example, now, I'm wearing shell tops, right? Now, some refer to them as what? Superstars. Amen? Now, shell tops have been around for what? A long time. They precede my birth, hallelujah. See, but you can put a modern twist on it and get them in Pepto-Bismol pink. Right. Oh, y'all don't want to talk to me.
Right.
Some of you ain't know what Pepto-Bismol is. Hallelujah. You know what Tums are, right? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. But nonetheless, a modern twist on something that's classic, or some would say old, but never goes out of style. And meditating on what to speak to the youth and what to speak even to the people of God is, don't get it twisted. God is the same yesterday, today, and forever. He's the Lord our God. And he does not change with the seasons, the times, the trends, the fashions, the technology. He's still the same. And what we have to realize is whether you are in possession right now of an iPhone 8 and you are ahead of the curve and you have this new Samsung that's not blowing up in people's pockets, hallelujah, God is still the same. And there's certain things and attributes about him that will not bend or flex, or they are not negotiable. Hallelujah. And young ladies, I want you to stand up because you're part of the message, amen? And go through the whole thing. You start saying, excuse me, do you know who I am? See, because I want you to understand something. Now, you might have saw her, and how many saw Raven and knew she was somebody? Yes. Now, without her opening up, you knew she was somebody. And some of you maybe that don't go here, you don't just know how much of somebody she is. Hallelujah. But nonetheless, you might have saw those sparkly Louboutin-esque high tops that she had on and said, she's somebody. And she could have just stopped right there, but then she got the socks, amen, to go up over it. If that didn't tell you, amen. Hallelujah. Then she had the sparkling pocketbook. If that didn't tell you, amen. She had the joy of the Lord bubbling up out of her. If that didn't do it, hallelujah. But then she had something to say. So go ahead. Start off. Say, go do your thing. From the beginning. In the beginning. Good, from the beginning.
Excuse me. Excuse me, everyone. Do you know who I am?
Who are you, girl?
I am a child of God. I am sanctified. I am the heir of the blessings of Abraham.
Come on.
I am not moved by what I see. I am blessed by his stripes. Dior, tell him who you are.
I am a child of God. I am more than a conqueror. I am strong in the Lord and the power of his might. I am an overcomer. I am the imitator of Jesus. Hey, Bella, why don't you tell me who you are?
I am a child of God. I am forgiven.
Thank you.
I am only above and not beneath.
Come on.
I am a new creature. I am the light of the world.
Yes. Amen. Thank you. May be seated, young ladies. Hallelujah. Now, they just pronounced who they are. And many of us can join in through the promises of God by faith that we are everything that they are. Some things they enumerated, other things they didn't express at one time, but God has said some things about all of us. However, if you go through life and you get too fancy and you begin to smell yourself, you begin to advance, you begin to gain a little bit of money, your house begins to extend and you get a few more rooms and a few more garages and a few more cars and a few more pairs of sneaks and a few more friends and your family extends, sometimes you think you are what you are by the amount of money you have in the bank. You begin to think you are what you are because of the lie that the mirror told you. And I know everyone's house has a trick mirror. It makes you look a little taller, a little skinnier, a little clearer. You think that's only Sleeping Beauty. Come on now. Uh-huh. You got a trick scale, too. Oh, yeah. You walk up for your checkup, you're like, oh, my goodness. This must be wrong. Then you get real deep. You ain't never used two syllables in your life. Excuse me, doctor, when's the last time you had this scale calibrated? But nonetheless, we begin to identify and we begin to look at ourselves by the wrong standards. Mother White, then we don't understand when we are the head and not the tail, and it seems like we're at the bottom of the barrel. When the Bible says nothing shall be impossible to us, and it seems like almost impossible for us to get a parking space. And we're wondering what's going on. You say, I am the head and not the tail. I'm above and not beneath. I'm blessed going in and blessed going out. But it seems like life is a curse. And you're wondering what's going on. Maybe because you're trying to balance your sheets by how much money you have. Maybe you're trying to balance your life by how people speak of you and what they think of you. Jesus said, if you love me, they're going to hate you. And it says, really, it got nothing to do with you anyway. He said, they didn't like me, and they're not going to like you either, because they recognize that you're associated with me. That's a blessing. Hallelujah. for everybody not to like you. And some of you need to get over it right now. It's because you're blessed, not because you're cursed, where sometimes you just can't get along. It's because certain vibes, see, they look nice, they call you their friend, but they're of their father, the devil. And light has nothing to do with darkness, and belief has nothing to do with unbelief. Nothing. See, but if you really know who you are, Manny, then you begin to operate as such. I got a hard circle, but wait, anyway, hallelujah. But you wonder sometimes what's going on, and God said, there's some things that we need to go back to. Hallelujah. We need to remember, hallelujah, because they are the active ingredients to every promise of God. Somebody say active ingredients. See, sometimes you'll be familiar with a product. And maybe it's green and white. But the company says, you know what? We're going to rebrand. We're going to give a new look. They give a new look, but guess what? It has the same contents. And on the label or table of contents, on the label, God, there'll be something in there, hallelujah, that stands out amongst everything else. And what's it called? Active ingredients. Hallelujah. And what the young ladies enumerated and what they shared, they're all the promises of God. Let me tell you something, saints. You are in this world, but you're not of this world. Amen. There should be nothing average about your life. But if you're trying to do things the way the world does them, you're going to be conformed to the world. But the scripture says, be not conformed to the world, but rather be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind with the word of God. Stop conforming yourself by the late night news. Stop conforming yourself by the latest jam. Stop conforming yourself by the latest trends. Stop conforming yourself by the social media trends. That's not who defines you, and that's not what activates the promises of God. You can be as new as you want, but all good and perfect things come from above, not from Foot Locker, not from Sneaker Villa, hallelujah, not from going to Dubai, not to going to South Beach, hallelujah. You can go wherever you want, but make sure wherever you go, when you put your foot down, you claim that territory for Jesus, hallelujah, and Him alone.
Amen.
Otherwise, you're going to find yourself in trouble. Everywhere I've gone, I've come back in one piece. Hallelujah. By the what? Grace of God. Not my kung fu technique. Hallelujah. Put your seatbelt on, but make sure God is driving. Otherwise, you're going to wreck yourself. Hallelujah. Why are you texting? Why are you drinking your coffee? Why are you looking in the back fussing at the kids? And everyone else on the road is doing the same thing. Lord, take the wheel. Hallelujah. But saints, you can't define yourself by these things. And apostles, sometimes, hallelujah, even somebody say, even the church. See, there's some churches, they're no longer a church. They're assembly. They're a congregation. They're a meeting. They're called communities. A church called by any other name is still what? A church. And hopefully, Jesus is Lord of that church. Because, Mother, last I read, there was one faith, one baptism, one Holy Spirit, one body. This is gospel, saints. You can't lift up your denomination higher than the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. There's a part that Catholics have right. There's a part the Baptists have right. There's a part the Lutherans have right. There's a part the Mennonites have right. There's a part, hallelujah, and we just need to play our what? Parts. Mm-hmm. Play your part. And young people, medium people, so-called older people, God doesn't change. Your socioeconomic bracket might change, but please don't change. Your health report might change, hopefully for the better, hallelujah, but please don't what? Change. It's not the medicine, hallelujah. It's Christ your healer, Christ your redeemer. It's the virtue, the same virtue that came out of his garment, hallelujah, the hem of his garment is the same virtue that's still coming out, touching whatever ailment, touching whatever situation, reconciling and bringing together that which was irreconcilable, raising the dead, It's like, well, that's nothing dead. Some of you got dead marriages. Some of you got dead bank accounts. Some of you got dead social lives. Some of you got dead ministries. Hallelujah. And I'm telling you, the same old remedy. You tried the doctor. You tried the lawyer. You tried the 10 steps that Creflo Dollar taught you. Hallelujah. And still got no better. Hey, but guess what? The solution doesn't change. Draw nigh unto God, and he will draw nigh unto you. Touch him. Hallelujah. And your situation will be made whole by faith. Hallelujah. Somebody say, I am. Everything God says I am. Hallelujah. But there's active ingredients. Hallelujah. There's active ingredients. And if you change the ingredients, you change the solution. It might not work the same. It might have the same packaging, same words on, but you pulled out the thing that makes it work. And God said there's some things in here that make his promises work. Hallelujah. Now, Shakespeare said it the other way. He said 500 years ago, he wrote and he said, you know what? He said, people are committing the oldest sins the newest ways. He said, but this stuff is old. Now, what if we begin to work the works of righteousness and we just did it in a fresh way? Jesus used to get in a boat, push himself in the middle of the lake, and then start talking, and there would be a lake effect, so it was amplified. He could speak to large crowds. But now you can post something that's edifying, and it'll go global. Hallelujah. You did old way, the gospel's supposedly old, but you just preached it in a new way. Hallelujah. But it's still the what? Gospel. And like Paul, you have to take a stand and say, I'm not ashamed of the gospel, because there's power in the gospel. Somebody say power. Saints, if you ain't got power today, you are in trouble. See, Mother White, it used to be a time, it was Sunday. You didn't have to worry about none on Sunday. They ain't play cards on Sunday. They ain't wash clothes on Sunday. People that cuss ain't cuss on Sunday. And if you were in the midst of a heated gang war, ain't nobody got hurt. Everybody got a pass on what? Sunday. Not today. Not today. They'll run up in the church and hurt you. You better have some what? Some power. But power don't come from your pink sneakers. Power don't come from how many horses you got underneath the hood. Your power don't come from how wonderful you think yourself is. The power don't come from how many followers you have on social media. You need active ingredients. Otherwise, it'll seem like they say over in Hebrews in the 4th chapter, it'll seem like God didn't know what he was talking about. It would appear as if God didn't know what he was doing. Yet he's omniscient and yet he's omnipotent. So there's nothing too hard, there's nothing unknown, and there's nothing impossible for him. So what's the problem? I gotta activate. Now, how many remember Jerry Curls? Y'all don't want to talk to me. Then you go see some of you jumped right in and was like, I didn't have a Jerry Curl. I had an S curl. Then some of you got real deep. I had a Jerry Curl S curl. I had an innovation curl. It's a process. Amen? But because we spent all that time and all that energy and thought it was so wonderful and had so much hope and stock in your curl, what would you do to your curl? You would do what? You would keep that thing active. At the cost of your leather couch, at the cost of your cotton white collar, at the cost of looking silly, like the guy coming back to America, so glow. As long as you kept that thing what? Activated. Saints, keep the promises of God what? Activated. How much more would you want to be the head and not the tail? Why would you want to live a dry life? Why would you want a dry bank account? Why would you want a dry marriage? Why would you want a dry business? Why would you want a dry debt? Why would you want a dry future? When all you had to do is take what God has given you and push on it, press on it, believe it now, and release it. Three main active ingredients set forth the promises of God. And I'm sorry, I know I look like I'm 20, I'm 45 years old. And I've seen enough, you know, I say you live long enough, maybe I'm going to live a lot longer, but I got a good view. If I make it to 90, by God's grace, that's wonderful. So I'm halfway there, I'm almost 46, so I'm over the hill, you would say. Chronologically, I'm not. In terms of my, telomeres? What do they call it? Telomeres. That's the end of your DNA. God is lengthening them and extending them right now. Amen? Because I'm activating it with my what? With my mouth. Because I got a mind too. Somebody say my mind.
My mind.
My mouth.
My mouth.
And my money.
And my money.
Y'all don't want to talk to me. Gucci ain't activating your telomeres. Just might shorten it. Hallelujah. Three active ingredients that activate the promises of God. Keep them flowing. Where you go to do something, you find out God's already done it because he knew it was close to your heart. Because you were delighted in him, hallelujah, and not how many pocketbooks you had. You were delighted in him and not how many likes you got on a picture. Hallelujah. Give me zero likes, hallelujah, as long as God is pleased. Says all the angels in heaven are rejoicing. Because I'm making moves in the kingdom.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Only those things done in Christ and for Christ shall last or remain. Hallelujah. What did Bob Marley say? I don't want to live in vain. I don't want to love in vain. Hallelujah. Live in purpose. Live in meaning. Achieving destiny. Helping to bring others. Hallelujah. To the same wonderful spot that you're in. Three active ingredients. Somebody say the blood. Somebody say the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah. The scriptures say there was some contentions going on in heaven. There were some accusations flying. And it says they never stopped. It says that the accusations were railing. They were rough. Hallelujah. And you got some stuff coming against you, saints. If you don't have something to counteract it, eventually, others are going to believe it, and you're going to start to believe it, too. You got to, woo-wee, every tongue that rises up. And see, I'm not talking about the tongue of the person at the cubicle next to you. I'm not talking about the tongue of the person that lives next to you. I'm not talking about the tongue of the person who's turned up their heel against you in your own household. That's not what I'm talking about. I'm talking about the tongue of the what? Evil one. The accuser of the brethren that accused the people of God both day and night. The people of God who are blameless. The people of God who are forgiven. The people of God who no charge can be laid against. It says it was counteracted. It was turned around, or somebody say the frivolous case was thrown out of court. Stand up. Pretend for a moment you're standing in front of the judge. And you got all these accusations against you. You're black. You're poor. You're female. You're only this height. You only have this amount of money in the bank. You got this doctor report. And they say, how do you plead? Somebody say, Your Honor, I plead the blood of Jesus! Somebody say, case? Dismissed. Have a seat. The blood. They don't want to talk about the blood anymore. I remember Creflo Dollar. He, huge church, giant ministry, bless him. He's an awesome teacher. So much more to him than you'll ever see. Outstanding. in so many ways. But he had an incident in his church, and somebody came in, and there was some shooting. It got really wild. And guess what he started preaching the next week? The blood of Jesus. Because he wondered how it creeped in. He wondered how all of a sudden the unthinkable now was taken into consideration. And he looked at himself and said, have I been keeping my curl tight? Have I been activating the promises of God? Or was I sitting around counting my money? Was I sitting around counting my members? Was I sitting around looking at how many pair of ministries I had? And he said, I forgot one thing. That's wonderful, but it ain't worth a hill of beans unless it's covered in the blood of Jesus. Revelation 10 says we overcame the evil one, not by our Cadillac. We overcame the evil one, not by our thick thighs and our slim waist. Oh, y'all. Some of you sold yourself to the devil for much less. I'm preaching good, right? I know I am, because y'all ain't saying nothing. Call conviction. Hallelujah. It's the blood of Jesus. It says we overcome the evil one by the blood of the Lamb. Somebody say the blood.
The blood.
Hallelujah. What shall wash away my sin? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. What shall make me whole again? Oh no, I got the psychiatrist. And they got Kanye out of the 302 situation. Kirk Franklin probably went up there and told him, son, it's the blood. And guess what? When he was all doped up and tied up, he probably said, I plead the blood. And guess what? He got right out. And as long as he keeps bleeding the blood, he'll stay out. And as long as we keep bleeding the blood, guess what? We'll be covered as well. Somebody say the blood. Shepherd mother, you're 70 plus, right? 70 plus, right? Touch foot pretty much on every continent on this planet, right? When people was talking about you slowing down, you see, anybody ever see The Flash? No, let's go to The Flash. $6 million man. And I'm going back, leave ages. Going back on you, Steve Austin. Y'all don't even know about that. But now the new TV, they got the new cable thing. They got all these digital channels. They put up the oldies but goodies on there. But it used to be a show called The $6 Million Man or The Bionic Man. Oh, come on now. I'm taking you back, but it's all right. I told you I was 45. When The Bionic Man ran fast, how did he run? He was like, come on now. You remember that, Scotty? He was busy watching the Westerns. And you suspended disbelief. He said, oh man, he running fast. Don't let Shepherd Mother fool you. She done been to China, California, and Texas. Why you thought she was sitting at home? You've been to the poppy store and back. We gotta pray for Shepherd Mother. She's not doing well. She going so fast. She's a 600 million bazillion trillion dollar woman. Let's give her a hand. Amen. Hallelujah. See how fast she got up today? They said, we'd like to honor. She was like, whoop. She didn't have to ask her to stand. Hallelujah. You may be seated, if you like. I'm just playing with you. Somebody say the blood of Jesus. It's an active ingredient. We overcome the evil one by the blood of the Lamb. Jim, come here. Now, Jim would be an example of modern classic. Now, Jim, how old are you?
44.
44. Father of three. Husband of one wife. Amen. Amen. Got a firm grip. Amen. Man on mission. He got many titles, many hats. Awesome man of God. But you ain't gonna see him in some Ferragamo pointy toe, 3-inch fashionable little quarter ankle boots. He said it's not his code. But what he'll do every now and then, he'll take what works for him, what is a part of his code, and when it gets a little dusty and rusty and messed up, what will you do? You'll detail him, but what? Sometimes you gotta what? Get a new pair. They call him what? I keep a what? I keep a what?
Fresh out of the box.
I keep a fresh pair of what? Trees. Hallelujah. Saints, it's the same tin. It's the same boot. Actually, if they changed it, you wouldn't what? You wouldn't want it. So, saints, why are you living by a gospel that's been perverted? Why have you, by the Spirit, gotten this far and now want to be perfected by the flesh? It's not going to take you where God has already brought you to. You may be seated. Thank you. He said, I keep the same style, the same proportions, the same dimensions. They're just fresh. So God said, I don't care if you put it on social media. Just make sure it glorifies me. He said, I don't care if your invitation to church looks like a club flyer. He said, just make sure you're drawing them to me. Because it's the same message, and it's the same what? Blood of Jesus that overcomes the evil one. Yes. Hallelujah. Someone say number two. Someone say active ingredients. Hallelujah. Active ingredients. Things that make something work. Things that pull everything together. Man, these past few months, I don't know what I did right. Hallelujah. But whatever I did, I got rid of the genetically modified ordination, the genetically modified prayer life, the genetically modified marriage, the genetically modified ministry, the genetically modified whatever it was. Hallelujah. And I went back to the blood.
Amen.
And things have been, so much better. Amen. Hallelujah. Somebody say number two. Somebody say the name.
Of Jesus.
There's no other name under heaven by which a man can be saved. It sounds fundamental, but we come in our name. We come in the name of Tom Ford. We come in the name of Louis Vuitton. We come in the name of Christian Dior. We come in the name, hallelujah, of our bishop. We come in the name, hallelujah, of this prophet. Hallelujah. You got to come in the name of Jesus. For there is no other name under heaven, on earth, or below the earth. Because last I read, at that name, every knee. Cancer has to bow at the knee of Jesus. Cancer don't care nothing about Fox News. Cancer don't care nothing about no institute in Tulsa. But at the name of Jesus, they tremble, they stumble, and they fall. We're going deep. Ooh, we didn't move, hallelujah, from the generic into the apostolic. But the apostles of old, they had no financial problems. They didn't even have need for money. Because whatever they needed, it fell from heaven. Whatever they needed, God supplied it. The sufficiency of God's grace was more than enough. Some of y'all are going to be like, oh my God, Pastor, preach. That thing was heavy. I got my promises activated. This is the oldest message in the world. We just giving you the Pepto-Bismol pink one. It's the same God. Yesterday, today, and forever. And he prefaces that statement over in James. He says, don't get it twisted. All good and perfect things came from above, are coming from above, and will continue to come from God above, the Father of lights, within whom there is no shadow of turning nor variableness. Jim, now if you see some trees that are a little suspect, you know, little Muhammad trees. I'm not messing with anybody, but they got them trees. And how do you know? Here's a good thing. They look like Tim's. They charge you like $5 less than real Tim's cost. But what happens when you got to put the Tim's to the test? They what? They start separating and falling apart at the seams. Now, you're laughing at Muhammad on 52nd Street selling you Tim's. Don't you think the devil is laughing? While your marriage is falling apart? While your finances are falling apart? Because he sold you something that wasn't worth anything.
Talk about it.
Somebody said the blood.
Blood
of Jesus. Somebody say
the name
of Jesus. Up to this point, you have asked me what? Nothing. We said, but now I want you to go ask the what? Father in heaven. But how's he say? How do you preface your request? How do you preface your petition? In my name. And your Father in heaven will give you everything that you ask for so that your joy may be made full. Some of you are like, let me wait till I get my money right, then I'm gonna get what I want. You already got the name of Jesus. You can have as much money, as much joy, as much peace, and as much life as you choose, but you have put the name of Jesus on hold and tried to get some Benjamins. Now, if I go over to Mark chapter 16, verse 15, what does he say? In my name, and somebody say, in the name of Jesus, I can cast out devils. In the name of Jesus, I can raise the dead. In the name of Jesus, something that was meant to do me harm and take me out, I can go on and live and not be bothered a bit. Not Jefferson. Not Hahnemann. Not Penn. Not Temple. Not Chestnut Hill. Hallelujah. Someone said the last ingredient. The cross. Turn with me over. I want you to see this. Turn. Look at Colossians chapter 2. The cross. The cross. Because Aaron, we are new. All things have passed away and all things have become new. But new is another word for fresh. And fresh doesn't always mean that you changed something. You just brought a clean, blessed version of what works. It's the blood of the Lamb. It's the name of Jesus. And saints, it's the cross. You know, most modern day churches don't even have crosses. And guess what else they lack? Power. Now, Raven came up here and she was all fancy and everything, and Aaron alluded to you, that's God's miracle. Did the doctors have any information for you?
No.
I'm sure some of them graduated from Harvard School of Medicine.
Yeah.
You went to the greatest of the greatest and they told you what?
That she was too healthy.
She was too healthy! In the midst of supposed disease.
Well.
bother with what God is doing, knowing that we want you to exchange our name and our procedure with the procedure in the name of God. Just keep doing whatever you've been doing, because what you've been doing is working. Let us get back to the people that are in this world without any activator. They need us. But you got understand the power and the authority that's attached to the name of Jesus. And the blood and the name work because of the work of Calvary. Hallelujah. Let's look here. Colossians. Hallelujah. Colossians chapter 2. Verse 13. Somebody say the cross. Somebody say, draw me near to the cross. I thank God for the cross. See, I didn't understand why they called, I always thought, you know, Black Friday is what? What day is Black Friday? Day after what? Thanksgiving. But like every Good Friday, I'd be like, oh, it's Black Friday. So the sun turned black and the curtain ripped, and I always thought, because I thought it was a black or a dark thing. And you know, you wondered why they put a spin on it and said it was what? Good Friday. Hallelujah. But because of Good Friday, guess what, Apostle? I can have a better Saturday. And because of the Good Friday and a better Saturday, I can have an even better Sunday. And then I mess around and realize that because of Good Friday and a better Saturday and an even better Sunday, say, I don't like Mondays, tell me why. Because you ran out of activator. You tried. You're like, thank God it's Friday. I always say, thank God it's Friday, because I get to meet God in prayer. 6 o'clock in the morning, 7:30 at night. Oh, I didn't get no hallelujah. Hallelujah. I said the cross. Whew, it's good. It's good. I can stand knowing that I've been forgiven. I can stand in front of anything that's opposing me, trying to take me out and trying to take me under. No matter how weak, no matter how feeble, no matter how painful, no matter how mixed up and weird it might be. The cross and the work has been accomplished. Somebody say, it's done. Woo. Some things you're going through, I'm here to tell you, they've already been finished. The scripture said, although the works were finished before the foundation of the world, the people still had to stand in what? Faith. All right. 2:13, we're out of here. So what are the three active ingredients? The blood. The blood of the Lamb, the name of Jesus, and the cross will activate every promises of God, and you will begin to see that you are everything God made you. And you being dead in sin, and the uncircumcision of your flesh, hath he quickened or made alive together with him, having forgiven you all trespasses. Someone said that's everything. Blotting out the handwriting of ordinances that were or was against us, which was contrary to us, didn't do us any good, and took it out of the way, nailing it to the cross. Let us stand. Somebody say, I'm God's elect. Who shall? They. Any charge against me?